It's so easy to dream of the days gone by. So hard to think of the times to come and the grace to accept every moment as a gift. Here's a gift that is given to some.
What can you do with the day?
Morning. It is so nice to see you. I am Lisa Larson, president of your Board of Trustees and board representative for the service today. If you're new or visiting us for the first time, we welcome you. If you have any questions, Steve and I will be in the community room after the service and would gladly answer any questions that you have. If you'd like to learn more about our church, visit our website at UUCW.org. That's UUCW.org. On to joys and concerns. We welcome you to share your joys and concerns. It's one of the ways we stay connected. You can do so on the green insert or by using the QR code that are both found in your order of service. I've been asked to share a brief personal story. So here goes. I am a long sleeper. I easily sleep 9 hours a night. My husband will attest to that. Fair warning, it's best not to call before 10 a.m. Well, this week has thrown me for a loop. We're having our roof and gutters done. It's been bang, bang, bang from the roof at 7:45. It's challenging my long-enjoyed 9 hour sleep schedule. At the beginning of the week, I woke up early and was rather irritated, but I'm happy to say by the end of the week, I could sleep right through it. So, at this time, I want to draw your attention to a few announcements. We are in the midst of our Together for Joy pledge drive. Thank you to everyone who's pledged. We're grateful for your support. We are at 43% of our goal for the new fiscal year, which begins May 1st. If you haven't yet pledged, now is the time. Staffing and program decisions are based on pledging. We can't spend money that we don't have. Our beloved UUCW community needs your support now. With the pledge returned far below our usual at this point in the year, we are already looking at cuts to things you will notice and likely care about. We will not be able to carry out business as usual with this much of a deficit. Pledge today, go to uucw.org/stewardship or to the purple button on your main on our main website page for all the information needed to make your pledge. Today is your last chance to attend a cottage meeting. Join host and UUCW treasurer Leslie Peterson. I believe she's here. Leslie, stand up. There she is. Woo-hoo! After the service, right here in the sanctuary, discuss the invaluable work and financial needs of our church community. No need to register, just drop in. And lastly, coffee. Who needs coffee? Who doesn't need coffee? Our coffee hour will return next Sunday to the community room after the worship service, but we need volunteers to brew and serve those delicious cups of coffee or decaf, caffeine or decaf. Thank you to Sean Calloway, who is heading up the coffee team and will offer training and guidance. Sign up with the links provided in your announcements or in the latest e-news.
Thank you, Lisa. Pardon me. My name is Steve Fry. I'm a member of the worship ministry team. We are delighted to have Patty Stevenson and Craig Sampson as our pulpit guests today. They are regional and national touring artists as well as members of this community. Pretty cool. I have one announcement to make, and that is you are permitted to sing as long as you keep your masks on today. That was changed and we just had kind of a typo, but it's all set. Whoever you are, from wherever you come, you are welcome here. Whomever you love, however you define family, you are welcome. The identities you hold, how you want to be called, and your pronouns are respected and welcomed here. Whatever the color of your skin, the language your grandparents spoke, the cultures that move in your being, the abilities and disabilities you hold, we welcome you. Whatever you believe, whatever your theology, prayer, or sacrament, even if none at all, we welcome you. We unite in Unitarian Universalist principles. We are a community of communities, spiritual seekers taking action, called on by our group to work for justice, united in covenant and the spirit of love. We welcome all of you. We welcome you here.
Please rise as you're willing and able and join us for hymn number 108. My life flows on in endless song above earth's love. I hear the real, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear the music ringing. It sounds an echo in my soul. How can I keep from singing? What through the tempest round me roars, I know the truth it liveth. What though the darkness round me close, songs in the night it giveth. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging, since love prevails in heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing when tyrants tremble sick with fear and hear their bedlam ringing, when friends rejoice both far and near, how can I keep from singing? To prison cell and dungeon vile, our thoughts with them are winging, when friends by shame are undefiled, how can I keep from singing?
Now is it on? Okay, good. Please read along, and if you are joining us at home, feel free to kindle your chalice or candle. It doesn't end in all growing from all earths to all skies, in all touching all things, in all soothing the aches of all years. It doesn't end.
Good morning. I'm Dave Cicero, Director of Lifespan Religious Education here at UUCW. My pronouns are he and him. It's a wonderful theme here happening today, right? The singing, the hymn that we just enjoyed singing. I'm going to be sharing a book today, a story called Change Sings. Today is about hope and change. The book is by Amanda Gorman, who's our poet laureate. And one of the themes is that is of being the change you'd like to see in the world. And I referred to this a couple weeks ago. And I figured I'd just, if you're not familiar with where that phrase comes from, the way I learned it is that it's a story of Mahatma Gandhi, who had a woman come to him one day and say, I'm in this terrible place. My son is addicted to sugar. And in India, this was a very serious thing. And it was wreaking havoc on the family. And she went to Gandhi, this great respected leader, to ask for his help. Humbly, please, can you help me? And Gandhi responded, come back to me in 2 weeks. And we'll see what I can do. And she was kind of distressed. She was like, oh, but this is very important. But she understood, I can't, you know, deny that request. Okay, fine. So she did. She came back in 2 weeks. And again, asked for that favor. Could you please help our family? My son is addicted to sugar. And he said, yes, I will. Let me speak with him. And so he did. He spoke with the son. And after some time, the son returned to the family and indeed had lost or given up that addiction. The mother was so grateful, went back to Gandhi and said, expressing this thanks and in all ways she could, but said, but I do have one question. I'm curious about that two-week delay, you know? Could you explain what that was about? And Gandhi explained, yes, when you came to me originally, I too was addicted to sugar. I could not help your son, until I became the change that I was hoping to see. So that's the story as I learned it. So I'll be reading the story today, Change Sings by Amanda Gorman, and pictures by Lauren Long. Publisher is Viking Books for Young Readers. I can hear change humming in its loudest, proudest song. I don't fear change coming, and so I sing along. I scream with the skies of red and blue streamers. I dream with the cries of tried and true dreamers. I am a chant that rises and sings and rings. There is hope where my change sings. Though some don't understand it, those windmills of mysteries, I sing with all the planet, and its hills of histories. I hum with 100 hearts, each of us lifting a hand. I use my strengths and my smarts, take a knee to make a stand. I'm bright as the light each day brings. There is love where my change sings. I show others tolerance, though it might take some courage. I don't make a taller fence, but fight to build a better bridge. I talk not only of distances, but from where and how we came. I also walk our differences to show we are the same. I'm a movement that roars and springs. There's a wave where my change sings. Change sings where? There, inside me. Because I'm the change I want to see. As I grow, it grows like seeds. I am just what the world needs. I'm the voice where freedom rings. You're the love your bright heart brings. We are the wave starting to spring, for we are the change we sing. We're what the world is becoming, and we know it won't be long. We all hear change strumming. Won't you sing along? So we all might identify changes that we feel are needed in our society and in our lives, personal, community-wide, and ask ourselves, what role can we play in that change? What might stop us from working for change? But maybe even more importantly today, and I think this is what Patty and Craig will be sharing with us, is, you know, exploring this idea of what source of motivation do we have to help us work for change. Now, the young people who are here today with us will be heading to the religious education classes. And so we'll sing them out with our recessional. We didn't plan for this. Do you? No, I was going to do it a cappella. That's just fine. As you go, may joy surround you. As you go, go in peace. Know our love is with you always. As you go,
sit comfortably. Notice what your legs are doing. Straighten your body, your upper body, but don't stiffen. Notice what your arms are doing. Soften your gaze. Feel your breath. Close your eyes and be kind to your wandering mind. Take a deep breath, low and slow, and exhale all the stress, and open your eyes. Good morning. It's good to see you. We are Patty and Craig, and we thought we'd explore the idea of change as an inevitable reality of life. While change is a constant on this world, we are at times visited by, in greater degrees, by impactful change in each of our lives. How do we measure change? We are surely not the same people in this room now as we were when we walked in, and yet we are. As humans, our perceptions of change are forever adjusting to what we are doing in the moment. We all know the adage that a watched teapot never boils. There is planetary and geologic change that we barely, if ever, perceive. There is the change of losing loved ones, enjoying a laugh with friends, or feeling the uncertainty of transition in a community or an organization. We here at UUCW are experiencing the upending change of transition, and Patty and I would like to explore hope and clarity this time, for us as individuals, as we, as a congregation, through words and through music. If you know any of these songs or it sounds suspiciously like a chorus, just feel free to jump in.
Sitting here in limbo, and I know it won't be long. Sitting here in limbo, like a bird without a song. Well, they're putting up resistance, but I know that my faith will lead me on. S- sitting here in limbo, waiting for the dice to roll. Sitting here in limbo, got some time to search my soul. Well, they're putting up resistance, but I know that my faith will lead me on. And I don't know where life will lead me, but I know where I've been. I can't say when life will show me, but I know what I see. Trying my hand at love and friendship, and all that's come and gone. This little boy is moving on. Sitting here in limbo, waiting for the tide to flow. Sitting here in limbo, knowing that I have to go. Well, they're putting up resistance, but I know that my faith will lead me on. I don't know where life will lead me, but I know where I've been. I can't say when life will show me, but I know what I've seen. Tried my hand at love and friendship, and all that's come and gone. This little boy is moving on. Here in limbo, and I know it won't be long. Sitting here in limbo, like a bird without a song. Well, they're putting up resistance, but I know that my faith will lead me on. Sitting in limbo, 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 limbo.
This poem is called Morning Awakening, Changing Beliefs, from a book, A Fierce Desire, by poet Penny Pritzel. Despite cancer, she wrote poems up to the last week of her life. I am adrift in a black sea, frightened. Out of chaos emerges order. Away, happiness. Go forth into the day. What can you learn? Be amazed. This is what you must do. Cut out words, sew them together as if you were making a dress. Wear them every day. Expect the best. Be joyful. Be amazed. It is all you can do.
So we're going to do a song that is one of my songs now. Just want to make sure I heard a string out of tune, so I want to make sure there's no pain in virtual world or in the present company. This song emerged one time we were in China embarking on an adventure of parenthood. And we saw a play. It was translated, but roughly what was happening was a master was, as a young guy, you know, his powers were coming to be known, and his teacher was saying, you have to be careful, because this can be dangerous. You have so much power within you. And of course, as a young guy, he abused that power, and as life will, it struck him down a little bit, and later on, as he gained wisdom, then he became a great master. So that was part of this song, the Genesis. Another part was Disney World. We were with our little daughter in that water slide, and you're in that long line, and the tunnel was all Brer Rabbit quotes. And so there's a Brer Rabbit quote in this song. And then finally, a friend of mine one time was expressing concern about something. I didn't know how to respond, so I said, well, it is what it is. And he said, oh, I hate that expression. So I thought, okay, that's going to be my next song. It is what it is. So here it is. It is what it is. It ain't what it ain't. It's nothing new, but I relate. You can't run from your troubles. Ain't no place that far. You can't run from yourself, so there you are. A drop of water leads to a sea. The love in a heart, that's you and me. A pretty little baby makes a family. The world rolls by and now I see. A second of time, an eternity. Believe in yourself and you'll be free. I trust in you, do you trust in me? Sit a little closer and sing to me. It is what it is. It ain't what it ain't. I ain't no sinner, but I relate. You can't run from your troubles. Ain't no place that far. You can't run from yourself. So there you are. Close your eyes, look around. Touch the sky, touch the ground. Nothing's lost, nothing's found. The future whispers soft, hear the sound. Smallest voice builds community. Friends help friends help family. The power of few is the power of one. The power of many like a ray of the sun. A child's hand is all you need. The world spins round and round and soon you'll see. If you keep loving your heart, and soon you'll be. You'll find that peace in you be. It is what it is. It ain't what it ain't. I ain't no sinner. I ain't no saint. You can't run from your troubles. Ain't no place that far. You can't run from yourself. So there you are. Thank you. From Nikki Giovanni, Our Own Path, from Make Me Rain. Sometimes we need to try on another person. We try on different shoes and socks, blouses and pants, and we think it might matter, better looking underwear. We need to try on patience and love, forgiveness, things of that nature. We need to remember we are good looking, smart, wonderful, and mostly we need to pick and choose who we listen to.
Bars and flows of angel hair and ice cream castles in the air, feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from bushfires snow, from up in town, and still somehow it's clouds' illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way to feel, as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go, and if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked in love from porcelain snow, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions I recall. I really don't know and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right aloud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way, but now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. Something's lost and something's gained in living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, from within doors, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life at all.
Joni Mitchell's Both Sides Now was written when Joni was in her early 20s, examining her life as she was going through change. When I hear the word change, especially the last 2 years, my honest reaction is to scream, no, and run the other way. But upon further reflection on the changes in my life, I realized that change can be a huge relief. It can also be amazing. Joni looked at clouds from both sides now. Craig and I got to see some clouds up close and personal. My cousin Rudy was a glider pilot until he was 80 years old. He offered to take any relative up for a free ride in the plane he built himself that had no engine. Not one relative took him up on it. Well, when Craig and I heard about it, we thought we would give it a try, but we did have some trepidation and a lot of questions. Rudy first talked about gravity, about the incredibly huge pull downward that gravity has on us. We're like, that's not helping, Rudy. He said as a pilot, he was always looking for the lift. He could stay up over 8 hours in that plane looking for the lift. I thought that was an amazing metaphor for life. There is so much in life that can pull us down and make us crash. I realized during the last 2 years that no matter what's going on in life, how much seems out of control, that every day, each of us has the opportunity to choose to be kind to someone. We can lift ourselves up, we can lift each other up, we can create the lift that will carry us through time, a true diamond of life. So some of the words to the next song are in your order of service, and they're also up here. I know it looks a little weird, but it'll make sense once we get started. It's called Beautiful Day, and I wrote it about living your dreams. It was inspired by that poet, Penny Pritzel. It goes, it's a beautiful day for a walk. It's a beautiful day for a long walk. Beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day for a walk. Beautiful day for friends, old friends. And then there are little verses in between, and then dreams gets to be done twice. So feel free to sing along, please.
It's a beautiful day for a walk. It's a beautiful day for a long walk. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day for a walk. It's a beautiful day for friends. It's a beautiful day for old friends. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day for friends. Not a minute to waste, she said to me. This could be her last chance, so speak your mind and stay a while. It's a beautiful day for a talk. It's a beautiful day for a long talk. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day for a talk. She said, look all around, listen to sounds you never heard before. Who knows what you will find, perhaps poems or maybe peace of mind. It's a beautiful day to explore. It's a beautiful day to explore. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day to explore. She said, search your soul, then live your dreams. Not a minute to waste, for tomorrow may be way too late. It's a beautiful day for dreams. It's a beautiful day for your own dreams. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day for your dreams. Not a minute to waste, she said to me. Though she left with a smile, her message echoes loud and clear. It's a beautiful day for dreams. It's a beautiful day for your own dreams. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful day for your dreams.
This is Wild Geese by Mary Oliver. Well, wait a second. Can I put your picks on?
Sure.
Okay. They click, so I'll wait. Okay. Oops.
And they drop.
Yeah. Okay.
Good?
Yes.
Okay, Wild Geese by Mary Oliver. You do not have to be good, and you do not have to walk on your knees for 100 miles through the desert repenting. You only have to let the soft animal of your body love what it loves. Tell me about despair, yours, and I will tell you mine. Meanwhile, the world goes on. Meanwhile, the sun and the clear pebbles of the rain are moving across the landscapes over the prairies and the deep trees, the mountains and the rivers. Meanwhile, the wild geese, high in the clean blue air, are heading home again. Whoever you are, no matter how lonely, the world offers itself to your imagination, calls to you like the wild geese, harsh and exciting, over and over, announcing your place in the family of things. Kind friends all gather round, something I must say, that what brings us here together is blessed us all today. Love has formed a circle that holds us all inside. Strangers are as family, and loneliness can't hide. Here's your part. So give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. Let's do that again. Give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love.
You sound beautiful.
Give yourself to love. I walk these mountains in the rain. I've learned to love the wind. Been up before the sunrise to watch the day begin. I always knew I'd find you, though I never did know how. Like sunshine on a cloudy day, you stand beside me now. Give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your heart to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. Love is born of fire, like a seed. Love can't give you everything, but it gives you what you need. Love comes when you're ready. Love comes when you're afraid. It'll be your greatest teacher, the best friend you have made. So give yourself to love. Love is what you're after. Open up your heart to tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. you. So Will Rogers said that sometimes one must wait until evening to see the splendid... Sometimes one must wait until evening to see how splendid the day has been. And I think that that's very true. Let us, in our community and in our care for one another, trust in our leadership and trust that we will make it through this transition and recognize the beautiful time that we have all shared together. And if you would now rise as you are willing and able, and we'll sing hymn number 131. Love will guide us, peace has tried us, hope inside us will lead the way. On the road from greed to giving, love will guide us through the hard night. If you cannot sing like angels, if you cannot speak before thousands, you can give from deep within you. You can change the world with your love. Love will guide us, peace has tried us, hope inside us will lead the way. On the road from greed to giving, love will guide us through the hard night.
Split the Plate is one of UUCW's programs of outreach and generosity. Each month, we give half of our undesignated offering monies to a nonprofit organization as a way to help us live our Unitarian Universalist values and to serve our community. For April, our Split the Plate partner is Project Return Milwaukee. Terry Woodley became involved with Project Return in 1995 when program volunteers came to the Milwaukee Women's Correction Center for a social and to let folks know about Project Return. She developed a strong relationship with her case manager, who eventually got her working with the Adult Center at Cross Lutheran. Terry recounts, "I met a lot of good women there who nurtured my spiritual growth." She has been a volunteer at the church in a number of capacities over the years. Eventually, she became a Project Return case manager, where she finds great joy in providing clients with the same love and support that she received when she came through the door. Terry is a continuing success story for Project Return, as well as their office manager. Here is Terry expressing her way of seeing the people she helps every day.
We don't treat people like they're criminal. We treat people like they are humans. Because a lot of places you go to, you see cages and you see all these bars and you see all this standoff stuff where we don't want these people touching us. We don't really want to get involved with them. We embrace these clients because these clients are human beings.
Project Return's good work needs our financial support. So please make your Split the Plate donation today. You can text and donate online or mail your contribution with the information found here. We thank you for your generosity to Project Return. The offertory will now be gratefully received. Thank you.
It's not on. There it is. Thank you again. Be True, Be Well, Be Loving by Cynthia Landrum. We leave this gathered community, but we don't leave our connection. Our concerns, our care for each other, our service to each other, to the world, and to our faith continues. Until we are together again, friends, be strong, be well, be true, be loving.
Well, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song, side by side. Well, we don't know what's coming tomorrow. Maybe it's trouble and sorrow, but we'll travel the road, sharing a load, side by side. Through all kinds of weather, what if the sky should fall? As long as we're together, well, it really doesn't matter at all. Well, they all had their quarrels and parted. We'll be the same as we started. Just travel along,